and welcome to the video. Today, you're gonna see me go grocery shopping because I don't have any groceries and I'm freaking hungry. How am I supposed to diet and eat healthy when I don't have any groceries in my house? So I don't cheat, I'm gonna go to the grocery store and fill up my drawers with some good, healthy food. So here comes an edit in 3, 2. Okay, I'm not Christian Guzman. I'm just gonna put an edit right now. So it is the next day. It is currently 11:52, so like 12 o'clock. And lately I haven't been hitting my macros until like late in the night, so I just started eating a little bit earlier. So about to cook some breakfast. I got 240 grams of these. This is my first time trying these. It's the simple potatoes, the Southwest style with hash browns. I'm gonna put that on the skillet right here. And then I'm gonna do some, saute some mushrooms. And then I got some egg whites right here. Got 230, so this is 5 eggs. And then I'm gonna do 2 whole eggs. Also, a quick update on my weight. I weighed myself this morning at like, it's like 187.6. So that is down 2 pounds since a week and a half ago, so I've jumped about 2 pounds in a week and a half, which is not too bad. My goal is probably cut down to about 170 pounds, so that's about 60 more pounds. Holy crap. Anyway, yeah. Alrighty, so I got my Monster on deck, and just get my mind right. Nope, I'm done. What day is it? It is arm day. I'm just sipping on my Monster. About to go kill it. Even though I've been in a caloric deficit, I've been having amazing workouts, like literally amazing. I've been getting crazy pumps. I'm just so super, super focused. I'm so dialed in with hitting my macros, getting my workouts in. I honestly do not feel like I'm dieting. I've been dieting for over 2 weeks. It's been about 2.5 weeks. I've never cheated once, which is like super rare for me. Normally like I have like a cheat day or cheat meal once a week, but I just have no urge to cheat. I'm just so freaking focused and I love it. All right, knock on wood. Okay, that's glass. But knock on something that this passion doesn't go away, because I need to go for my full probably 12 weeks of this cut. Gotta get down to 170. Gotta look good for myself. All right, I'm gonna go to the gym and I'll see you guys there. Okay, so the first movement we're starting off with is closed grip bench. Now, I like to start off every single workout with a compound movement to overload the muscle. So what a compound movement is that you're using more than one muscle. So for example, for this movement, it's mainly focused on the triceps, but you have a lot of synergist muscles. Synergists are just helper muscles. For example, in this particular movement, you're also using your shoulders, you're using a little bit of your chest, you're even like using a little bit of your lats to help you with this movement. Versus an isolation movement, let's say you do an isolation bicep curl, you're just focusing on that bicep. So I like to start off with a compound movement to lift the most amount of weight,
overload the muscle, and then I'll break it down. So we're gonna start off with close grip bench, followed by some heavy curls. So let's get it.
Okay, so right after the close grip bench, you immediately come here to do your bicep set, and this is all a superset, so that means there's no breaks. I mean, I'm taking a break right now to record this clip, but I'm only gonna record one clip, but everything I do is four sets. So you do close grip bench, followed over here, and then you do this. This can be a pyramid as well as the close grip bench. We're gonna start with a lighter weight for about 12 to 15. Each set is gonna get a little bit heavier, so that means we can't do as many reps, so let's get it.
I bet it will. Do the numbers, I said it will. I played the game and I'm still the same and I never changed.
So now that we got a compound movement out of the way for the tricep and the bicep, now we're gonna do a unilateral movement. As you can probably guess, unilateral means that each arm is working independently. And the reason that I love doing unilateral movements is that to make sure that each arm is working independently, so there's no imbalances and that each muscle is firing at its own rate. Because when you do a bicep curl, If this arm is weaker, your right arm is gonna compensate for it, and vice versa. Versus if you're doing a bicep curl with one arm or a tricep extension with one arm, each arm has to work individually. And so you know that if on the right arm you get 8 reps, on the left arm you get 7 reps, that your left arm isn't as strong as your right arm. So that's why I love doing unilateral movements, and it's also very, very important. So that's what we're gonna do. I'm gonna start off with tricep extension, and then we're gonna do some hammer curls for the long head of the bicep. And then the overhead is for the long head of the tricep. Because our bicep has three heads, our tricep has three heads, our bicep has two heads. So let's get it. As always, I like to start off my first weight about 12 to 15 reps, and then each set I like to get a little bit heavier every single time. And everything I'm doing is four sets. I'm only gonna show you one set of each exercise, but everything I do is supersets, everything I do is four sets. So let's get it.
Nothing like it's nothing, yeah, you know I done it. Now there's no discussion, bitch, I'm ballin'. I made a promise to my mama, I'ma turn these zeros into tens of commas. Bitch, I'm ballin'.
Okay, so the next superset is gonna be what I call Jesus curls, because you're gonna have your arms extended like this, and then you're just gonna be like an isolation curl. Just gonna do four sets of that, about 12-15 reps, and then we're gonna superset that with just a basic row pull down, and at the bottom try to pull apart as possible. So we've done our compound movement, we've done our unilateral movement. Then the next two supersets are gonna be isolation movements, just to kinda, we've like pretty exhausted the muscle, the bicep and the tricep, and now we're just trying to completely destroy it. So that's what we're gonna do, so.
Just drop the verse, I need a cop of hers, cause I'm fresh to death. I bet you never-